Hey guys, Dave Panozzo here. I want to go over a couple of the things that you need for mindset. Now, mindset is something that is only in you. It is not in anyone else. This isn't something that you get motivation to get mindset. This isn't motivation, oh, I'm going to drink a rock star and get mindset. Mindset is something that happens in your mind. Now remember, when you can start to control your thoughts, you will end up controlling your mindset. Now this isn't some voodoo ritual stuff, but you have to have a mindset in today's world to be able to handle the ups and downs of business. And I have been through a lot of different things. I have lost everything. I have gotten it back. I got sober. I went through the learning curves of almost getting divorced. So let me tell you, my mind is very strong, but it took decades for me to get this in place. If I would have known some of the things I know today, back then, it could have been a completely different game changer for me. So I want to instill with you guys today, 7 things that really, really helped me out. Number 1, everything is possible. Everything. If you think you can't, you can't. If you think you can, you can. It's possible. You just have to put your mind to it and know that you put 100% effort behind whatever it is you're doing. Now guys, I'm telling you, there were times back in my past where I gave up and I felt sorry for myself. I don't do that anymore. My losses are minutes or maybe an hour long. That's it. I move on to the next. It's crazy what happens over time. I look back at myself and I think, oh my God, I was being such a little snivelly. Passion. Passion's number 2. Passion is something that you have to feel inside of you. Passion is what makes things happen. If you're not passionate about doing something, guess what? You're not going to want to do it. If you have to take out the garbage, be passionate about it. If you have to do a chore around the house, clean dishes, clean your house, make your bed, be passionate about it. It's easy to get caught up in these little things. Oh, I don't want to do it. That's not, you have to be passionate about it. If you can't be passionate about cleaning your dishes in your sink, and you're not passionate about making your bed in the morning, how are you going to be passionate in front of a client? Oh, well, Dave, it's different when I'm in front of clients. Well, if it's different, then that means you're being fake. And people don't want to deal with fake people. They want to deal with authentic people. Here's something else. This one, guys, blows me away. Number 3, you want to be connected around other people that are thinking like you. Like minds think alike. If you are running around with a group of people that are kind of in that naysayer, complainer, always coming up with problems but no solutions, that is definitely not the mindset of people you want to be around. Because what's going to happen is, like the old saying goes, if you stop in at a barber shop enough times, you'll eventually get a haircut. Be around positive mindset people. That's the only way to do it. Start separating yourself from the old crowd. You are in growth mode. You are looking to do bigger and better things. You're not going to do it around your own crowd. Well, Dave, I don't want to, you know, those friendships mean a lot. Well, if the friendships mean a lot, then those friends are going to support you in your new endeavors, in the level that you're going to go to, in the new mindset, in this growth mindset. If your friends really, really do like and love you, they'll support you. The ones that don't worry about it. One of my favorites is number 4. You have to be 100% accountable. I'm even gonna throw this out. You might even need to be 110% accountable. Because if you're waiting around for someone to hold you accountable, you're not gonna get past go. You have to be the one to be able to hold yourself accountable in order to execute whatever it may be in front of you. If you need to get up early, my alarm clock goes off at 4:29 a.m. every morning. Why? Because I hold myself accountable to a different level. And by doing so, I execute on my own. I don't have to wait on my wife. I don't have to get someone calling me to wake me up. I do it on my own because I hold myself accountable. Now, why is this important? Well, in business, there are going to be certain things that no one will be able to hold you accountable except for you. And that makes the difference in going to the next level. Hey guys, Dave Panozzo here. Real quick, I want to interrupt this video to share this with you. If you are struggling or got something going on in your business that is just kicking your ass, listen, I want to help you. So text the number below, get back, okay? We're going to get back your time. We're going to get back to the basics. We're going to get your mind right. Let's get you making some money and make it now. Now, again, text get back to the number that you see below, and I'll reach out to you. As always, make it a great day. Now back to this video. Now here's one of my favorites too, is gratitude. You have to have gratitude in your everyday, everything that you do. You have to have the feeling of gratitude. Gratitude is the difference between making and breaking something that you're in. For example, sometimes I'll get in a little bit of a funk. And what I'll do is I'll come up with my gratitude list of 25 things that I am grateful for. Now, the first couple days that I do this little exercise to get myself back on track, I find the first couple days I'm saying stuff like, I'm grateful for being alive. I'm grateful for a roof over my head. I'm grateful for having food in the fridge, like the basic 101s. Now here's the difference between day one and day five. On day five, I'm saying things like, I am grateful to be alive because I get to do what I love to do. I'm grateful for the love that my wife gives me, and I'm grateful for the love I give her. You see, it starts to go a little deeper. And as you start to go deeper in how you feel with gratitude, it starts to become contagious with the other people around you. And you'll have people tell you, wow, Dave, you're in a really good mood. Yeah, because I'm full of gratitude. This is free stuff, by the way, okay? These are things that you can do to self-police. Next one, live to give. This is number six, live to give. This is where you have to fall in love with giving to others with no expectations in return. This is something that I love to do. I'll be honest with you. I hate receiving because it makes me feel guilty. That's on me. But I love to give. I love to give my knowledge to people of things that I've gone through because I want to help them. Do I also give to the church? Absolutely. Do I give to others on my team? Absolutely. When you live to give, your life will turn around. There's kind of this thing a while back, I heard this story, and this guy only had a couple bucks left in his pocket, and he saw a mother and son out on a date. The child was younger, the mom was, you know, of course, a mother, and he was watching the interaction between the two, and he just was kind of overwhelmed with just joyous feeling. And at the time, this gentleman didn't have a lot of money on him, but what he did was he gave that mother and son $20 for their dinner. Now take in mind, this isn't this past week, this was years ago when things were a little more affordable, but he gave them $20 and said, I'm buying you two dinner tonight. By that pure act of giving, That individual ended up a couple days later receiving some of the biggest contracts he had ever had since his company started. And again, this is where giving comes back tenfold to you. So I want you to learn how to give. And the last one, number 7, is time. The time is now to execute these things. Don't wait till tomorrow, because we're not guaranteed tomorrow. Now, I had a few health scares a couple years ago. I didn't know if I was gonna make it. Got COVID, I was in the hospital, couldn't see my family. It was all FaceTime and phone calls. And I was at a point to where, oh my God, like, I might not ever see my family again. Like, this could literally be it for me. And when I got out of that hospital, I was so grateful to see my family. And I told myself, from now on, I'm not waiting for tomorrow. I'm not waiting for next week. I am going to do whatever it is that is in my mind. I'm going to do it now. We are on limited time, guys and gals. We don't know when our time is up. And I surely don't want to be at the pearly gates someday and they said, well, you know, you had this opportunity to really make an impact on life, but you blew it off and you waited too long, and so now you're here. I want to make sure each day I don't leave anything on the table, and that if I can do something, just one more thing, to make a difference in someone else's life, my life, I'm going to do it. Now, I hope these 7 things of positive mindsets helped you. There's going to be a number down below that I want you to shoot a text, mindsets. I'd love to get on a personal call with you, go over what it is you're going through, and see if I can get you to the next level.